students, today we are going to discuss about the radioactive series. As you had studied about the law of radioactive decay and the how to calculate the half-life time and the average time period, so next we proceed to the radioactive series. Since the radioactive material is capable of disintegration and it is emitting alpha particles and beta particles, so it has been found by Rutherford and Soddy that the radioactive materials disintegrate into a series of particles to end up into a daughter nucleus, that is the stable end product. So in nature, there had been found to be four types of radioactive series. These four types of radioactive series has been classified as depending upon the mass numbers. So when the mass number A is the multiple of n, that is multiplied by 4, that is it is the 4n, means it is a series which in which the mass number is a 4 times the multiple of the natural number. We have one type of series which is named as the thorium series. And if the mass number is 4 multiplied by n plus 1 series, so if that series is called the neptunium series. In the uranium series, it is named as 4n plus 2 series, and in the actinium series, it is named as 4n plus 3 series. So why are these series named as 4n, 4n plus 1, 4n plus 2 and 4n plus 3? So in this series, supposing we have the thorium series, so our parent nucleus is thorium-232. So whatever these series are emitting out, it would emit either alpha particle or beta particle. So when a series is emitting alpha particle or beta particle, we know that if we have a parent nucleus ZXA and it is emitting out a alpha particle, then the daughter nucleus formed will be Z minus 2 and A minus 4. So the mass number A when it is emitting alpha particle is decreased by 4. So since here in the case of thorium-232, when it emits an alpha particle, whenever it is going from right side to left side, so always there is a decrease in the mass number by 4. So here it is 232, so the next daughter nucleus formed is radon-228. So it is decreased by 228. And if the parent nucleus is emitting a beta particle, suppose we have ZXA emit alpha beta particle, that is minus 1 electron 0, then the atomic number increases by 1, but the mass number remains same, that is it is having A as well as A in the parent and the daughter nucleus, means the parent and the daughter nucleus so formed are the isobars. They have different atomic numbers but the mass numbers are same. So as you can see here that the radon is emitting beta particles. When in the series it is moving from left to right, then a beta particle is emitted. So here one beta particle is emitted out. So radon changes to the daughter nucleus actinium with the atomic number of 228. And when it is moving to thorium, again it is an isobar and it becomes thorium-228. So now when the thorium disintegrates, it is emitting out alpha particles because here it is going from right to left. So again the thorium-228 mass number is decreased by 4, it becomes radon-224. Then radium-224, then again it emits an alpha particle, it becomes radon-220. Again it emits an alpha particle, it becomes polonium-216. Again it disintegrates and emits an alpha particle, it becomes lead-212. So here lead-212 emits a beta particle, it becomes bismuth-212. So lead and bismuth are isobars with the mass number 212. Again bismuth releases a beta particle, so it becomes polonium. So again here we can see here we have three isobars, lead, bismuth and polonium with the mass number of 212. So bismuth can disintegrate leading to thallium by emitting an alpha particle, or polonium can form lead by giving out the beta particle as lead-206, or here thallium liberates a beta particle and becomes a stable end product, that is the lead-206. So in the thorium series, what we had found, that the numbers are 232, 228, 224, 220, 216. All these mass numbers are a multiple of 4. Supposing we say here as 206. So 206 divided by 4. Or we say a number 212. Here it would be 208. Okay. It is thallium 208. And here also it is lead 208. So for 212 we have divisible by 4. So we get 4 5s are 20 and we have 12. So 4 3s are 12. So again we see that this lead 212 is what? This is a multiple of 4. If we see radon 220. So 220 is again a multiple of 4. 45. 228, it is again a multiple of 4. So all the successive daughter nucleus that are formed in the series are all the multiples of 4. So that is why the thorium series is named as A equal to 4N, because all the successive daughter nucleus that are formed are the multiples of 4. So we have in the thorium series, the parent nucleus was thorium-232, where there were successive liberations of alpha and beta particles leading to a stable end product, that is a daughter nucleus of lead-208. Here also, if we see our neptunium series, the neptunium series is named as 4N plus 1. So 237 is 236 plus 1. So it is 4 into 59 plus 1. So that is why the neptunium series is termed as 4N plus 1, because it is a multiple of 4 and there is an additional 1 number in the masses of the daughter nucleus or the parent nucleus. So again we start, whenever we are moving from right to left, there would be an alpha decay. Whenever we are moving from right to left, and when we are moving from left to right, there would be a beta decay. So neptunium changes into palladium, then we have uranium, then thorium, then radon, then actinium, francium, then bismuth, polonium, thallium, lead and bismuth. So in the neptunium series, what we have that the parent nucleus is our neptunium-237 and the end product, that is the daughter nucleus, is our bismuth-209. So what we say in bismuth-209 also, it is 208 plus 1, that is 4 into 52 plus 1. So it is again the series of 4N plus 1. That is why the neptunium series is regarded as 4N plus 1 series. So also in this graph we have shown here that along the x-axis we have represented the atomic numbers, as whereas the along the y-axis we have represented the number of neutrons. How much neutron or how much proton number is being changed when disintegration takes place for a particular series. Similarly, if we look for the uranium series, this uranium series has been named as A is equal to 4N plus 2, means it is a multiple of 4 and there is an additional 2 factor that is accounting for the mass number of the various daughter nucleus or the parent nucleus of the series. So here we have uranium-238, so 238 can be regarded as 236 plus 2. So 236 can be written as 4 into 59 plus 2. So I think you understand this is 4N plus 2 series. So again, when we are moving from right to left, we have an alpha disintegration, alpha particle is released, and whenever we move from left to right, we have the beta particles. So from uranium-238, it forms the thorium, then palladium, then uranium, thorium, radon, and radium, polonium, lead, bismuth, polonium, thallium, lead, polonium, lead. So here our final end product is the lead. So whenever there is a beta emissions, so what we say, we find that in the beta emissions we have a series of isobars. So in this term you can see that lead-214 after liberating the beta particle from bismuth-214, beta bismuth after liberating beta particle forms polonium-214. So lead-214, bismuth-214 and polonium-214 as a series of the isobars that can be formed during a particular uranium series. So here what we see. So if we want to come to bismuth 210, we had supposing we have the parent nucleus as bismuth 214. So bismuth 214 can be changed to bismuth 210 by a series of process. Either bismuth can liberate alpha particle and then a beta particle to form bismuth 210, or it can liberate first alpha particle. It can liberate first beta particle forming polonium 214 and then liberate an alpha particle forming bismuth 210. So it can change to one parent can become one daughter by a series of changes. It is not necessary that first only alpha particle should be liberated and then beta particle should be liberated. It could be done that one beta particle could be liberated first and then alpha particle is liberated out. If there is a chain that alpha and beta are liberated. So it doesn't mind that whether first which particle is liberated, but it should be in continuity that both the particles are liberated in succession. So this term is known as the branching. So as we can see here, supposing we have this parent nucleus. So our parent is radium C with mass number 214 and with Z atomic number 83 as the mass number. So it liberates first beta particle to form radium C with the mass number of 214 and atomic number 84. So we know that whenever the parent nucleus is liberating a beta particle or an electron, so the Y, what happens to the daughter nucleus? If it is having ZXA, the daughter nucleus atomic number is increased by 1. So here you can see that this parent had having the atomic number 83. So here this daughter nucleus is having the atomic number 84. But the masses number remains same. That is A is remaining A. So here it was A 214. So here also you can see the mass number as 214. So this both these two nuclei can be called as the, they can be regarded as the isobars. Now when we form radium for 84 atomic number, it releases an alpha particle to form a daughter nucleus radium B. That is, since it is liberating an alpha particle. So when an alpha particle is liberated out, that is 2He4. So what happens? We have a daughter nucleus whose atomic number is reduced by 2. Z is changed to Z minus 2 and the mass number is reduced by 4. So A is changed to A minus 4. So here we had the mass number 214. So in radium D, what will be the mass number? Mass number will be 210. And the 84 was the atomic number. So 84 atomic number is now reduced by 2. So it has become 82. As we saw here, that Z would be changed to Z minus 2 and A would be changed to A minus 4. So 214 changed to 210 and 84 changed to 82. So one path is that radium C first emits out beta particle and then emits out an alpha particle. Or it can also follow another path where it is first liberating out the alpha particle. If it is first liberating out alpha particle, then 214 changes to 210 and 83 changes to 81, because the atomic number has to be reduced by 2 and the mass number has to be reduced by 4. Now when it changes with 2, it liberates out beta particle, then 81 has to be increased by 1. So here radium D has been increased by 1 to 82 and 210, the mass numbers remains the same in the case of the beta emissions. So we again have the same daughter nucleus, that is radium D 82 and 210. So what we see here, this is termed as the branching. So branching means that we can have different branches for a single parent nucleus to reach to a particular daughter nucleus. But the path could be different. Either it could be following that first it liberates beta particle then alpha particle to arrive to a particular daughter nucleus. Or it could again take another part disintegrating with alpha particle and then with beta particle. But it is always said that alpha and beta, one alpha one beta could be equal to one beta one alpha disintegration. It is not there that there could be two alphas and on the other part there are two betas to lead to a particular daughter nucleus. So the number of particles that are emitted, that are constant, but how they are liberated, which order they are liberated, that could be changed. So this is meaning of the branching. So here in the series of the thorium, neptunium, uranium and actinium series, so where do we see the branching? So this portion represents the branching. Again here also you can see this portion is showing you the branching, where bismuth can lead to 113 by any of the path, either first by releasing beta then alpha, or it could release first alpha and then beta. Similarly, you can see for neptunium series and here also for actinium series. So this portion here, there are two branching shown at this portion and at this portion. So let us now come to the actinium series. So actinium series is regarded as the 4N plus 3 series. So 235, uranium 235 can be represented as 232 plus 3. So it is 4 into 58 plus 3. So all the successive daughter nuclei that are formed during the series follows the mass number having the relation as 4N plus 3. It can be expressed as the multiple of 4 plus an additional 3 factor. So uranium liberates alpha particle to form thorium, then it liberates beta particle to form palladium, then actinium, and actinium can show branching here it first liberates alpha particle then beta particle, or it liberates first beta particle then alpha particle to form the radium 223, then it liberates an alpha particle to form radon 219, then polonium, then lead. Then lead disintegrates to form bismuth by emitting out the beta particle. So again at bismuth there is a branching. It liberates first alpha particle then beta particle, and bismuth is here also showing a branching where it is liberating first beta particle then alpha particle to form the stable daughter nucleus, that is the lead 207. So lead 207, for 207 again we see, so 207 can be represented as 204 plus 3, that is 51 plus 4 into 51 plus 3. So again this is again the 4N plus 3 series, where all the successive nuclei that are formed during the various series transmutations all are following the mass number equal to 4N plus 3 rule. So we can see that if we have the fifth series of 4N plus 4, so 4N plus 4 will be what? 4N plus 4 can be written as 4 into N plus 1. So again this series corresponds to the thorium 4N plus 4N series. So in nature there are total of 4 series, that is 4N, 4N plus 1, 4N plus 2 and 4N plus 3, where it is called the thorium series, neptunium series, uranium series and the actinium series. So to form the radioactive series, Rutherford and Soddy had given some rules, that is we have to balance the atomic number as well as the atomic number, that is the electrical charges, which is given by the number of protons, and we have to balance also the mass numbers. So it is said that the algebraic sum of the electrical charges, atomic number before disintegration, that is before disintegration, that is the parent nucleus, whatever is on the left hand side, their atomic numbers had to be added up, and after disintegration whatever the products are formed, all the atomic numbers have to be added up. So if we see here, when we add 2 and z minus 2, what we get? Z. And on the left hand side we have z. So the electrical charges or the atomic numbers are balanced in our equation. So this is what given by the first point, that the algebraic sum of electrical charges, that is the atomic number before disintegration, must be equal to the sum of electrical charges after disintegration. Similarly, the rule holds for the mass number, that the algebraic sum of the mass number of the initial particles or before disintegration must be equal to the sum of the mass number of the product particles after disintegration. So the sum of the mass number of the initial and the final particles must be same or equal. As in the case here, we have on the left hand side we have the mass number A, but on the right hand side we have two product particles, that is helium and the Y, that is the daughter nucleus. So when we add 4 and A minus 4, we get the answer as A. So the A is balanced on both the left hand side and right hand side. So we say that the algebraic sum of the atomic number as well as the algebraic sum of the mass number, both on the left hand side and the right hand side, should be equal. So we have to follow this rule to form our any series, radioactive series. And we have studied that a particular parent nucleus can form a daughter nucleus through any path. It could first release an alpha particle, then beta particle, or it could lead to another path by liberating first beta and then alpha. So this process is called as the branching. So in this way, we can now calculate the law of successive transmutations or successive transformations. So now we shall study the law of successive transformation in our next module. So thank you.